Hello Starfa, it is a glorious morning. I have just stayed overnight and now I am about to find some orchard grass for Camilla Turnstone. On my way out I'm going to pick some Timothy grass, so I have that in my backpack because that's good to have. You may notice that the heart up here is completely black. I think that is because I left my game on for a very long time without caring for the horse. Partly because I want to see if the day rhythm would reset automatically. I think it never did. I think it just stayed when it became night and then I had to sleep overnight to reset it. I think it took about 20 minutes or so. And I also, well, I left it on because I didn't really dare to, well, close it down because of all the very strange microphone settings. So I left it on while I was eating dinner, and yeah, apparently my horse did not like that. I'm not entirely sure what that means. I think it is like how well you're taking care of the horse. This should be the horse's well-being as of like right now, and if it turns purple and then pink, the horse is feeling very bad. That's so strange, by the way. I have no idea why they decided to add that there. I am going to find some orchard grass. There we go. There are a couple of really strange design decisions in this game, but also, I mean, I know a lot of the designers, or a couple at least, and programmers who worked on this game, and I'm guessing that they want to try stuff out because I know they like to experiment a bit. And also, this game is so old and game design hadn't really come to what it is today back then. I mean, if you look at many old games, all of them, or many of them, are quite lacking. So I'm not gonna blame them for that. Come on, horse. One thing that's good in this game, this also applies to Star Stable Online, if you ever get stuck somewhere and you're like, oh, I really want to get up there, but I can't, just turn your horse around and go backwards along the way, because that works really well. So if you like fall down a cliff here, you can almost do that. Unfortunately, you cannot call for pickup here, which can make stuff quite a bit complicated, but if you dismount your horse and run to a race and you start that, the horse will have to be automatically transferred to the race, so that's a way to, well, to get loose if you ever get stuck somewhere. I can't go any faster here because the horse will not be able to make it, so I will have to go super slow. Just trying to find the grass so I can go back up again. I need two more. I'm going to leave the Timothy grass up there. The orchard grass isn't really, I don't use it a lot. And it gives quite a lot of like extra with the horse's hunger, but I think the Timothy grass works quite good anyway, so I usually give that. And it says that you should get a 20 plus endurance bonus with the orchard or the Timothy grass, and I don't really know how that works because it doesn't have that yellow background that is needed for you to be able to feed your horse when you're sitting on it. And I don't think that you get a timer that times down how long the horse will have that bonus, so I think that might be a bug, I'm not entirely sure. Since this system was never used again, I mean, you had carrots and apples in, at least in the Winter Rider, I'm not sure about the Spring and Summer Rider, but you couldn't really pick them anyway, you had to buy them, so if you wanted the bonus you had to spend some money, you don't have to do it here. So I think it might be a bug that you have it, like the endurance bonus, but I don't know. Like, some things are difficult to understand in this game. Like, it took me, I think, several years to understand that this icon means you can jump over something. And it literally, it only shows up when you are in a canter or goes faster, because that means that, oh, so now you're going fast enough to jump. Took me ages to understand what that arrow meant, because that little tiny bar there, I had no idea. I think it's supposed to be like a log or something, but I really did not understand that when I started playing this. We're just going up to give Camilla her orchard grass, then we're going to accept the next quest, and then we are leaving to find Lisa. That's another grass, we can't pick that yet, because we're going to learn how to pick that soon. And I'm not really looking forward to meeting Lisa, because, not because I don't like her, she is my least favorite soul rider, but anyway, it's simply because her, I don't really like her race. I think that that's kind of boring race. There's no jumps or anything, and you just run around in circles, and it's not really fun. So, but anyway, we're going to do it. I need to do a couple of races and like complete them in order for me to be able to buy more horses, or not more, if I want to exchange this horse. Because I do want to exchange the horse, I would like to have at least 3 horses by the end of this video, or end this video series, just to give you guys something new to look at instead of the old horse all the time. And to do that I need to be able to train them for a bit. And I need a couple of races being like done so I can train off camera, because I don't want to do stuff that you can't see. So now we're going to find some fescue grass. And this is very much spread out, so it will be a bit difficult for us to find it now. So instead of trying to find it, we will just go to Lisa instead and have a look at the old windmill. And you can see it over there. That's where we're supposed to go. Lisa's standing right next to it. The first time I saw old... what's it called? Mill Hill of Will in SSO, I thought that was the same place. I don't think it is, really. I'm not sure if SSO has a version of this site. I don't think so. I'm just gonna pick this. But of course, since I played these games so much, I always try to find comparisons when I started playing SSO. And you couldn't always find it. Like, when I first saw the winery, I was like, whoa, what is this? And I was so confused. It took me a couple of days to actually find my way around it. And that was way before the riding hall didn't exist back then, so you couldn't go down to the beach. And Golden Hills Valley did not exist at all either. It was just like, I think it was like mountains, so you couldn't go there. You know, when you first could see Golden Hills Valley on the map, you couldn't even see that it was autumny. Like, everything was just green. So, the game has changed a lot. I had so much difficulty to maneuver around the first few days playing SSO. And, like, I know this map quite well now, but I would not say that I know it very well, because this is a difficult game to find your way around in. Just because it's so big, it's so vast, it's like, you don't really have anything to look at because there's so few memorable places. We're gonna pick up the map again so we can see what star we'll collect here. But there are, like, very few places to find. Mistfallen Dundle doesn't exist, you can't go to Golden Leaf Stable, and stuff like that. So, Old Mill, Windmill is the third star. And here is Lisa, and as you can see, she does not have Starshine with her. Just as with Linda, who did not have Meteor with her. And their horses does not show up at all in the entire game series. So, this is the quest from Herman that we now are leaving with Lisa. Apparently Herman was just here, but, well, now I'm here, and he's gone. So she's going to teach me about endurance riding. We're also gonna give her the letter, also from Herman. I don't know why he went here, if, like, why did he give me the letter then? So, the Claymore challenge at the McKinney Castle. So, of course, we need to practice a lot in order to be able to go to the McKinney Castle. So now we have 3 different quests. One will lead us back to Hillcrest, which is this one. Lisa's horse needs some sort of vitamin brew, so we need to pick Jorvik berries and clover, and then we need to go back to Camilla Turnstone. She's of course a pharmacist in this game, not a veterinarian. Then we're gonna do the quest longer and faster, which means that we're going to find turnips. And turnips is another crop that we can find to feed our horse. And now when we have finished that quest, we will be able to pick turnips at any time and give to the horse. Which is super good, of course. Also, if we stop, have a look here. I'm just going to show you where you can find turnips. Ah, stop. Here you go. It's kind of difficult to see because we have so many dots out here now. But you can see that down here we have quite a lot. And we have a couple on the way here from the top of Devil's Gap, which should be like the Forgotten Fields. Up to Valedale, across what is today the winery fields. And also a couple of them in Feargrove, not a lot. So, yeah. Yeah, that's it. So, let's see. I was trying to turn around while standing still, but I can't right now. I'm just trying to turn around. I have to move in order to turn. I also need to find a water well so I can refill my bucket, because I will need to water my horse a lot now. That's one thing I don't like here with the windmill as well. It's quite far to the next campsite, so that isn't very nice. Okay, so I'm gonna pick some turnips quickly, so I have some extra food. Not sure. I think there's another one around here. There, yeah. I'm just gonna pick this one, and then they will respawn anyway, so... we should do this race at least one time. Trying to figure out when it would be best for me to buy another horse. What level am I? Level 4. I'm guessing at level 7 I should be able to get a couple of horses at least, so then I can decide what horse I think would be most fitting to have for a while. So now we're going to try the endurance course here. And I don't think it's very fun. It's like, it's okay, but I don't think it's a very fun course. But also, I've done this so many times that might add to why I don't really like it. Just going to leave this up there. And I have 4 minutes to finish this. They have quite long races in this game, and they aren't always super good. Like, they aren't always very fun to play. But also, like, this is an old game. You'll have to do it where it is. I feel like I missed the checkpoint, but I don't think I did. No. It's just very far between the checkpoints, so you're also a bit confused if you aren't really sure what you're doing. That's out of, by the way. We're going to have a look there later in the game. But I think I will need the best possible horse, because the race down there is quite difficult, really. You need to have a fast horse, and I think that you even need to have some bonuses by feeding it with like turnips and carrots and stuff. Or at least I thought it was super difficult when I was younger. I didn't find it that difficult when I did my playthrough in Swedish for this game. I did that like 4 years ago, I think. Yeah, I did that in 2014, so it was 4 years ago. So I have played through all these games on camera previously, but I did in another language. So I did the Swedish, and of course I narrated everything in Swedish. It's very strange to do it in another language than your own. It's quite fun too, like it's a good challenge. And I always need to practice my English. I do speak English daily at work, because we are an international company and a lot of people doesn't speak Swedish, so of course we who are Swedish need to adapt. So it's always good to practice. I also write a lot in English at work, and I mean, you did get a lot of practice when you were in school. I haven't been in school for a couple of years now, so it's very good to keep on practicing like, outside of work too, so you keep your language up to par. It would be nice to know a third language. I did take French for a couple of years, and then I took Mandarin for 2 years. I did French 4 years and Mandarin for 2 years. I'm dreadful in both of them. But Mandarin was really fun. I want to continue study that at one point in my life. That was super fun, really. I liked the grammar. Like, I really thought it made a lot of sense. Okay, so now we have finished endurance course. Maybe we should do everything at once. Because I was... Because as you know, I was considering doing, like, one video where I only try to gain medals. But I think that won't really help me at all. I think that would be difficult for me if I want to have different horses. So maybe I shouldn't do that. Oh well. Okay, so now I'm going to add some more skill points to myself. And as previously, I will not care a lot about the caring. Because soon I will get only like 20 points. And then I can't give it, like, distribute them evenly. So then I'm going to add some more to caring. I don't really need to have much caring, but I just want to make sure that it doesn't fall away too much, because I'm not sure if anything like bad can happen if I don't give the points here. But I just want to make sure that the horse is cared for, and I think that might help me in like that the health won't fall down as quickly as well. I'm not entirely sure, don't know. Also, I have saved up on a lot of stable points. Herman! Well, I'm on my way to become Claymore challenge material. That's nice. Thanks, Herman. Thanks for believing in me. Okay, so I need to brush up some horses. I really need to find some water. But I'm fine with the hunger. And that's too bad because it's so easy to find food. But I need water. Should we perhaps do the course again? We should. Let's just finish this. Let's do it! So now I have the maximum time of 3:30. I didn't even look to see how I did last time, but I know that I can finish this course quite quickly. Let's just go find it. So as you can see now, my horse's endurance is falling. Not as quickly as when I showed you this in the beginning of the game. But it is falling, and I will need to keep that in mind. It's even worse if I push the horse once more, but I won't right now, because he's so slow anyway. And I will, like, do everything within the time limit, so I don't care. Also, whenever I jump, you see that the endurance goes up again. So, let's see here when the endurance goes down. It's the endurance. Exhaustion, its name. Yeah, don't drink and ride, kids. Oh well, look at the exhaustion bars. Okay, so you see now that the bar is going down, so I will take a jump, like here, and it goes up again. So that's good to know when you're doing during cross-country rides. That's very good to know, because then you can always push the horse quite a lot, and as long as you just have like the right distance to an obstacle, you can jump that and gain some exhaustion back. So that's good. Why the fuck? One horsey. So we might even do this within the 2 minute mark. But I really want to get some more water. I really would like to have more than only 5 like water buckets with me. I can only have maximum 5. In Starship you can have 12, I believe. You can only have 3 previously in SSO, but that was changed to 12, which is so nice. But it would have been really nice to have 12 here too, because the water is really needed here. Okay, so if we have a look here, we see that we will have these medals now. But I probably will survive without water. So let's go for silver immediately. I think my horse is getting like... Yeah, the only thing left is endurance. We'll have to look and see if I get my endurance added during this ride, or I think that might be something I will have to do with Alex. Don't really recall. It's difficult for me to remember what bonuses you get from each race, because I haven't really played in such a long time. Or I have, as I mentioned previously, I have played in a separate game file in order to prepare for some upcoming videos I want to do. But I haven't really looked at stats and stuff, because I just want to get through the game so I can buy all the horses and go to all the areas and stuff. And I can go to all the areas right now if I want to, but I won't really gain anything. I might get some experience from finding new areas, but not enough in order for me to actually level up. So I won't get any new quests, because a lot of quests are depending on each other. So I will have to do quests anyway in order to just get through the game. But I did realize, because when I played this in Swedish 4 years ago, I realized after I had finished the entire series, I was like, okay, so I'm done with this, bye. Then I realized I'd actually missed a quest. I think it was one of the Fear Group quests, because I don't hang out there that much. Fear Group is quite boring in this game. So I completely missed out, and I was like, oh, then shoot, I forgot to have this on camera. So I'm not gonna do this time. This time I'm going to show you all of the quests. I really need to buy her another jacket too. Like, I really dislike how slim she is. She looks a bit anorectic. Don't like that. Like, the play character in SSO is very slim too, but she does not look as terrible as this one do. There we go. So, within the 2 minute mark again, I'm going to give Dopey some water before we continue on. And also, I'm going to feed him. I'm guessing, like, Timothy? Should be a good choice. Yeah, and maybe a carrot. Just because he's pretty. And so a brush up and some water. I think he might need all my water. No, maybe just two. Okay, so I have one left. But I think we may run across a campsite when we go looking for Jorvik berries, so that's good. Because I think that we might have to sleep overnight soon, at least within a couple of minutes. So now it's time for us to do the gold challenge. And now my maximum time limit is 2:30, and of course I will do it within that time limit. It won't be very difficult. I will try to remember to get up some turnips after finishing this too. Let's just go for it. It's always good to have a lot of turnips in your bag, as well as carrots and apples. So whenever I go back to areas like Paddock Island, I always pick a lot of carrots so I have in my backpack. Oh! The endurance must have gone up! Yeah, it did! Because as you know, the exhaustion bar is moving at all. Oh no! Oh well. Let's just go for it then. Now the exhaustion bar will go down. But it's fine. So you see, you can push your horse even more, but it won't be very happy with you. So I'm gonna try to jump to gain some exhaustion back. So I can push him a bit more here. See, the sun is setting now. I will need to find a campsite quite soon. But I have done it a couple of... I think we're about done with the episode of the day anyway, so... I don't really have to do much more today. I'm just going to find a campsite. Also, of course, this is one of the slowest horses in this game, so it will be a lot faster when I get a faster horse. I will not get any of the horses that are slower than this one. I want a faster horse immediately. But then, of course, I will buy the best horse of the game for the end competition. There we go. See her. Oh, look. I love that they are unique. I really wish that we would get that for all the races in Star Stable Online one day. But I mean, there are so many races in SSO, so I understand why it hasn't happened, but I really wish we will have it one day. That's on my wish list. Great. So now you can see the blue exclamation mark, which of course means this is a daily quest, and I can do it. But I can do that as many times as I like, because we don't have any notice boards in this game. Any notice boards for races, that is. So I'm going to go to campsite, which I will not be able to find because that's not the campsite. That is the grass I'm supposed to find. And I know we have clovers and berries around here. Where is the closest campsite? Down by the water, I believe. What was that? It was fescue grass. Which gives 20 in discipline. Nice. But none in hunger. Oh, I know that I always have difficulties finding a campsite around here. That's a bit of an issue. I will have to go north if I can't find anything here. But I really want to get my berries. Yeah, there's one. I see it. I see it on the map now. Perfect timing as well. Now the sun is setting. Do you see it? There we go. So I'm going to refill my water. I'm going to stay overnight. And then we're going out on new adventures next week. I think we'll begin by getting the berries and clover for Camilla Turnstone. And we might return to Hillcrest. I'm not entirely sure. but we'll see what we will do next time. If you have any questions, don't forget to drop them in my comment down below. If you haven't subscribed already, please do so if you want to see more like this. And I really hope I will see you all next week.